Hello guys, welcome to another video on calculus, and today we're discussing the fundamental theorems of calculus, of which there are two, and as the name suggests, they're very important, so important that they're essentially fundamental. Let's first examine the first fundamental theorem of calculus. And for that, we will need to define some function f of t that is continuous on an interval from a to b, and some point x that falls between a and b. And for convenience sake, we're going to place it in the middle just so that you can see a little better. And now we define a new function a of x, which could be capital F of X. A lot of people use that when they talk about the formula for the fundamental theorem, but I decided to call it A because we're dealing with areas. So it's just a letter that fits and is a bit more intuitive to my mind. Anyway, so our function A of X is a definite integral on an interval from A to point X. So from here to here, and it falls, as we've mentioned before, the point x falls between a and b. So now that we've defined the function, here's something interesting. The punchline of this whole theorem is that if you take our function a of x and make it a prime of x or differentiate it, you end up, drumroll, with the original function f. So essentially that means that the derivative of the integral is the original function, or in other words, if we take that and reverse that, we're taking some function and we're finding the antiderivative of that function. And that's exactly what an integral is. It's a derivative that has been reversed into its original state pre-differentiation. This is denoted as a prime of x equals to f of x. Here, we can draw our a of x. So this area here is our a of x. And right now we'll need that to actually demonstrate the second fundamental theorem of calculus, which deals with calculations for definite integrals. And you know, if you've seen our video on the basics of integration, we've already done a calculation like that, but we didn't really go into details of where that comes from and, you know, why it's done exactly this way. And the answer is it comes from the second fundamental theorem of calculus. The second fundamental theorem of calculus graphically looks something like this. We have our point X and we have our point A. And what this area A of X equals to is essentially the area when calculated with respect to X minus the area when calculated with respect to A. And if you look at our definition of A of X, A goes to the lower boundary, and in case of A with respect to A also goes to the upper boundary, and that by definition would give us zero. So in this case, we're subtracting A with respect to X from zero from A with respect to X, and that just leaves us with A with respect to X, which is our area. And if we wanted to find the area, let's say between X and B, we would find A with respect to B, and we would then subtract from that A with respect to X. So this section here would be subtracted from this entire interval from A to B, giving us this. What would remain would be the area under the curve from X to B. And that's what we represent in this equation here of the second fundamental theorem, that the definite integral from some lower bound A to some upper bound B of a function ft is essentially the antiderivative of that function calculated with respect to B, and then from that we subtract the antiderivative calculated with respect to A. and we get our area under the curve. So there you have it. That's the second fundamental theorem of calculus. And hopefully now you're not confused anymore by where all of those rules of integration come from and how to think about them. And from now on, I hope that you can apply this knowledge at least to give your professor a satisfying answer. Thank you very much for watching. Do not forget to like and subscribe, and stay tuned for more mathematics videos.